Today is World Refugee Day, a day to honor and celebrate you, the refugees. We reflect not just on what you have endured, fleeing your homeland, separation from family and friends, hardship and loss, but also what you have accomplished, your commitment to carry on despite the challenges, your courage and determination to rebuild your lives. You never cease to inspire me and my colleagues at UNHCR, and we will continue to work for you. Yet we also recognize that it isn't enough. The best assistance is no replacement for an end to conflict, for a solution to your plight, or as a substitute to lessen the longing for a safe return home. 2020 has been a challenging year. The COVID-19 pandemic has generated a health and socioeconomic crisis on an unprecedented global scale. The virus knows no border and has affected each and every one of us, refugees and displaced people included. Despite the many challenges, we have witnessed extraordinary levels of support and solidarity, both for refugees, but also by refugees. Refugees like Carmen Parra, a doctor from Venezuela, who is now working long shifts as part of an ambulance crew in Peru. Or Heval Kelly, a Syrian refugee and cardiologist at a large American hospital, who is also volunteering at a COVID testing center in the United States. We have seen and heard countless other stories of refugees supporting the response in their host countries, often taking personal risks to give back to the communities that have provided them with protection. This week, I asked the members of the United Nations Security Council not to turn their backs on refugees. I urged them to solve the causes of displacement, and I again conveyed refugees' remarkable resilience, something that I have long admired and which gives me hope even in the darkest of situations. And so, on this World Refugee Day, I celebrate and thank you, the refugees, for setting an example for the rest of the world in how to remain strong in crisis and overcome adversity.